TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 23rd of December. India's ruling party holds massive rally in support of new citizenship law. Global terror watchdog hands down 150 questions to Pakistan. And Afghanistan's Ghani claims narrow win in preliminary vote results. Now for all the details. India's ruling party, Janata Party, on Monday held a massive rally in West Bengal province to counter the protest against the Citizenship Amendment Act across India. This came a day after Prime Minister Narendra Modi defended the new religion-based law during a campaign rally in New Delhi and denied any religious bias.
National Working President of India's ruling Bharatiya Janata Party or BJP, JP Nadda, on Monday kicked off a massive rally in Kolkata city of West Bengal province in support of the Citizenship Amendment Act or CAA. The bill paves the way to citizenship to persecuted non-Muslims from Afghanistan, Bangladesh and Pakistan that entered India before 2015. Accompanied by other senior BJP leaders, Nadda blamed the opposition parties of misleading people on the issue and lambasted critics who say the new law undermines India's secular constitution as it does not include Muslims. The issue has been a major flashpoint in politics in West Bengal, with Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee declaring that it will not be implemented in the province.
Ye jan sailab bata raha hai ki sare Pashchim Bengal se log aakar आज कलकत्ता में अब एक तरीके से भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेतृत्व में प्रदर्शन करते हुए बता रहे हैं कि सेंट्रल सिटीजंस अमेंडमेंट एक्ट जो एक्ट पास हुआ है उसका समर्थन कर रहे हैं.
Meanwhile, protests against the new citizenship law continued across southern India on Monday. Protesters carried Indian flags, posters, placards and raised slogans as they demanded the government to repeal CAA. In southern Chennai city, president of regional Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam party, M.K. Stalin, also staged a massive rally to protest against the act. Widespread demonstrations have continued across India since the passing of the bill on December 11th.
A fire that broke out in a godown in Indian capital New Delhi killed at least 9 people on Monday. The incident happened when the building that housed the cloth godown caught fire due to a short circuit, which was swallowed by a cylinder blast.
At least 9 people, including 3 children, were killed in a fire that broke out in a cloth godown in Indian capital New Delhi on Monday. The incident happened around midnight when the building that housed a cloth godown on the ground floor caught fire due to a short circuit, which was followed by a cylinder blast. On receiving the information, fire tenders were rushed to the spot to douse the fire, and rescue workers recovered the bodies and shifted the injured to the hospital.
कपड़े का गोदाम था जिसमें आग लगी और ऊपर दो परिवार सोए हुए थे. एक हाउस के ओनर थे और हाउस के ओनर का परिवार था और दूसरी जगह पर में किराएदारों का परिवार था और दोनों परिवार इस पूरी तरह से आग के चपेटे में आ गए. जाहिर सी बात है घर था तो सिलेंडर वगैरह भी थे, गैस सिलेंडर वगैरह, तो गैस सिलेंडर के फटने की वजह से भी काफ़ी उसमें एक्सप्लोजन हुआ है और जैसी जानकारी मिली है कि 9 लोगों की डेथ हो गई है.
The incident comes days after 43 people were killed in New Delhi fire that swept through a 6-story factory where laborers were sleeping. In most places across India, fire safety regulations are lax and not periodically reviewed, which results in major fires leading to loss of life and property.
The Financial Action Task Force has sought more clarifications and data from Pakistan on actions taken by it against madrasas belonging to banned outfits. This came weeks after Islamabad submitted a report to the Paris-based body detailing steps taken by the country to curb terrorism and money laundering.
The Financial Action Task Force or FATF has sent 150 questions to Pakistan, seeking clarifications, updates, and most importantly, actions taken against the madrasas belonging to proscribed outfits. Pakistani media reports said FATF raised the set of questions in an email weeks after Islamabad submitted a compliance report on December 6. The global terror financing watchdog had in October this year kept Pakistan on the grey list for an extended period till February 2020. The FATF had said Pakistan must demonstrate effective implementation of targeted financial sanctions against all UN-designated terrorists, included Hafiz Saeed, the founder of Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group. Hafiz Saeed led Jamaat-ud-Dawa or JUD's network reportedly includes around 300 seminaries and schools. JUD is also believed to be the front organization for the Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group, which is responsible for carrying out the 2008 Mumbai terror attacks.
Moving on, several lawyers recently held a protest in Gilgit-Baltistan against a controversial bill which allows the relatives of members of the assembly to assume jobs in the courts in the illegally occupied region. The disgruntled lawyers said the bill deprives deserving candidates of their rights and jobs.
Several lawyers took to the streets in Gilgit-Baltistan recently to protest against a controversial bill passed earlier this month that allows relatives of the assembly members to assume jobs in the courts. Terming it as a black bill and murder of merit-based system, the lawyers protested in front of the Gilgit-Baltistan Assembly and the Chief Minister House against the legislation that supports only kinship. The disgruntled lawyers said the bill deprives deserving and competent candidates of their rights and jobs.
This protest has one purpose, that Gilgit-Baltistan has merit, baladasti ho, rule of law, so that Gilgit-Baltistan's poor people, who are competent, capable people, can get merit pay mulazimate mil sake. Lekin aapko pata hai Gilgit-Baltistan ki ye riwayat rahi hai ki chand ek logon ke liye guzste saalon ke andar bhi is kisam ka gair kanuni bill pesh karke sainkdon logon ko permanent kiya gaya aur wahi riwayat apnate hue abhi bhi gair kanuni bill pass karke Gilgit-Baltistan ke naam nahat assembly ne apne rishtedaron ko permanent karne ki koshish ki jiski hum sakti se mazmat karte hain.
Nepotism in the recruitment process for any government job in Gilgit-Baltistan has remained deep rooted for decades. The government of Pakistan has never allowed any policies or legislation to be formulated in the illegally occupied territory that could benefit the locals and bring development in the region.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani appears to have narrowly won a second term, according to preliminary results from September's balloting that were announced on Sunday. His main challenger, however, rejected the outcome as illegitimate.
Afghanistan's incumbent president Ashraf Ghani won a slim majority of votes in September 28 election. Delayed preliminary results showed on Sunday. The Independent Election Commissioner IEC in the country said the total turnout in the presidential election was more than 1.8 million, with Ghani securing 50.64%, enough to win the first round of voting. Ghani, in a television speech on Sunday, welcomed the result and promised to serve the Afghans equally. Kabul residents also gave mixed reactions about the announcement, as many Afghans fear a profoundly flawed vote.
هدف تیم دولت ساز خدمت مساوی برای هر افغان مساوی در این کشور.
Meanwhile, Ghani's main challenger Abdullah Abdullah, who currently shares power with the president in a unity government, has refused preliminary results and blamed the Independent Election Commission for fraudulent vote counting. Last month, the IEC began recounting thousands of votes due to what it described as discrepancies in its system.
ماز کمیسیون شکایت انتخاباتی توقع داریم که در مطابقت با قانون با دقت شکایت‌هایی را که ثبت شده و ثبت میشه در مورد قانونیش مورد بررسی قرار بدن، آرای تقلبی را جدا کنن و نتایج در مطابقت با قانون ارائه کنن، در مطابقت با طرز العمل ها ارائه کنن.
The election result comes at a critical time for Afghanistan, as the United States is showing more interest in negotiating a peace settlement with the Taliban to end a war that has dragged on for more than 18 years.
More news from Afghanistan. The Taliban on Monday killed a United States service member during clashes with both Afghan and U.S. forces in Afghanistan's Kunduz province. This comes as U.S. negotiators have announced a break from peace talks with the group post a Taliban claimed attack on a key military base in Afghanistan.
The Taliban on Monday claimed responsibility for killing a United States service member during clashes with U.S. and Afghan government forces in Afghanistan's northern Kunduz province. A Taliban spokesman in a tweet on Monday said, the combined forces were targeted with IED, which killed the U.S. force member in Kunduz. About 20,000 foreign troops, most of them American, are in Afghanistan as part of a U.S.-led NATO mission to train, assist and advise Afghan forces. Some U.S. forces also carried out counter-terrorism operations against militant groups. The United States has been in negotiations with the Taliban over the past year on a deal under which the U.S. could withdraw its forces from its longest war in exchange for Taliban security guarantees. This month, U.S. negotiators said they would take a break from the talks after the insurgents launched a suicide attack on a large U.S. base.
Hundreds of fatherless brides tied the nuptial knot at a mass wedding organized by a businessman in India's western Surat city. Young couples belonging to different religions wore colorful ethnic attires as their wedding rituals were performed at the grand event.
As many as 271 fatherless brides tied the nuptial knot at a mass wedding ceremony held recently in Surat city of India's western Gujarat province. Brides dressed in crimson attire, donning jewellery set with their grooms and performed wedding rituals according to different traditions. Organizer Mahesh Bhai Savani, a businessman, said till date he has arranged and funded weddings of over 2,700 girls belonging to different communities.
मेरा कोई भाई या फिर बहन भी नहीं है और यहाँ पे मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि मेरी शादी यहाँ पे हो रही है.
Mass weddings are becoming very popular, especially among the economically backward sections of Indian society, as these reduce the worries of financial implications among the parents or guardians of the brides. Conventionally, the family of a bride in India is expected to bear the expenses of a lavish wedding and also give dowry to the bridegroom deemed as gifts to the bride, which could be in cash or kind.
Christmas festivities have begun in parts of India. Christians form less than 3% of the country's more than 1 billion population. But Christmas is widely celebrated in metros and other big cities with much pomp, gaiety and devotion.
Christmas fever has begun to grip India ahead of the festivities of the winter holiday season. School students were joined by residents of India's southern Thiruvananthapuram city recently, as they wore Christmas-themed costumes and marched with a band playing carols in a procession. The students also enacted scenes from biblical stories in tableaus that they paraded in the city during the procession.
It was a very wonderful experience to participate in this great Santa Fest. We are proud to be dressed like this and perform the Santa Claus. We know this is Christmas is going to be Christmas. We are celebrating it because we to enjoy with all the other members of the Roman Catholics in this Trivandrum.
India's financial hub Mumbai also saw people spreading Christmas cheer to children at a mall with circus performers and Santa Claus. The performers exchanged joy and merriness with the visitors and also clicked pictures with them.
हर त्यौहार हम लोग मनाते हैं तो ये त्यौहार भी हम लोग जस्ट टू स्प्रेड जॉय हैप्पीनेस एंड गुड चीयर अभी शुरू करेंगे अगले साल के क्रिसमस तक इसको फॉलो करेंगे उसके लिए आए हैं.
Christians form less than 3% of India's more than 1 billion population, but Christmas is now widely celebrated in metros and other big cities with much pomp, fervor and devotion.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on SadeshiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SadeshiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @SadeshiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.